I'm going to drop some truth on you. I'm going to drop some knowledge on you. I hope you're ready for it. Muslims, the Quran, copied the Holy Bible in the year 400. In the year 1800, Jehovah's Witness copied the Holy Bible. In the year 1880, Mormons copied the Holy Bible. What can I say? What can I denounce it? I denounce the devil. The devilish religions. Why are they devilish? Oh, come on now. Timeline. Jesus came, God, to reinforce the law, right? Correct? Okay. And give the ultimate sacrifice. Those two reasons. There was nothing. Oh, you know what? My bad. I'm God. You know, I just created Adam and Eve, and I know what happens 5 million years later from now. Like, I know Jared's going to be born. I know everything that's going to happen. But I forgot. My bad. You know, I need to bring, you know, the last prophet, Muhammad. He needs to clear some things up. My mistake. Wrong. Muslims, you're wrong. Jehovah's Witness, you're wrong. Mormons, you're wrong. Sup, bruh? Are you against God? Get out of here with that crap. You think God makes mistakes? Really? Oh, man. Year 1800. You know what? Some things need to be... Yeah. Mormons, yep. Jehovah's Witness, yep. This is the truth. There was corruption back there. This is now the truth. Get out of here, bruh. No. But you want to know what does make sense? I'll tell you what makes sense. Satan, the deceiver of the light. Yeah, man, I'm going to get these idiots. I'm going to bring up some new religions. I'm going to tell them this is the truth. It'll be the same God. They'll all worship the same God, but I'm going to change some stuff up so I can create division. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Use your brain that God gave you. You think God's like, oh, shoot. You know what? There's more than just the Old Testament now. Or the New Testament, excuse me. Right here? Yeah? The ultimate sacrifice. Past, present, future sins forgiven. No. Don't misunderstand that scripture. Don't misunderstand the scriptures. It's not like you just live in sin, kissing on the devil, touching the devil, laying the devil, sleeping with the devil. Think you're still going to inherit the kingdom of God? Are you nuts? Try twisting the scriptures to fit your flesh? No. Judgment day is going to come. Now, across all these other religions, right? Muslim, their little Quran, right? Jehovah's Witness, the Mormons, right? All these other religions. There's a foundation, and it's the only thing that matters. Have Jesus Christ in your heart, right? In your heart. When your faith is true, you're now a holy temple. You shall not defile it with sin. Simple as that. Repent when you fall short, not when you intentionally sin. It's a difference. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 26, the scariest scripture. No. Not Matthew. Is it Matthew? I could be wrong. Right? And they will look to me. And they'll say, Lord, Lord, we prophesied in your name. We did this in your name. We did that in your name. Be gone, for I never met you. Those whose faith is shaky, yeah, that might be the scariest scripture. But when you know your faith is true and you are walking in Jesus' footsteps as he did, you fall short, but you grab on and you pull yourself back up. Lord, I'm sorry. Forgive me for all my sins. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise you, God. Thank you, Jesus. A difference between falling short and choosing to indulge in sin, touch the devil, dance with the devil. Big difference there. Once saved, always saved. The only way that doctrine exists is when it's coming out of Jesus Christ's mouth. Faith. Not humans with their love. So shaky, falling, not sturdy, not a rock. Jesus' faith, pure rock, the true meaning. Meaning, you ain't sinning now, buddy. Use your brain. The Lord gave it to you. You think God's going to be like, oh, crap. I made a mistake. I know everything that's going to happen 2,000 years from now, 5,000 years from now, but I made a mistake. Let me get some prophets. Let me rewrite some things. Let me add some things. In the year 400 with the Quran, right? And then Muhammad, the last prophet, right? Right? The revelation, the book of Revelation changes. You can now, oh, a brother went to hell, but I went to heaven. I can take him on out of that. What? What? Nah. Nah. Mm-mm. No. Use your brain. God gave it to you. You think he makes mistakes? You think he's like, oh, shoot. The ultimate sacrifice. But there's more. No. There's not more. There's not more. That's just it. There's not more. This is the truth. Mormons, use your brain. God gave it to you. Jehovah's Witness, use your brain. God gave it to you. Muslims, copy the Holy Bible. Changing the book of Revelation. Do you realize you've damned yourself to hell? Hold right there. All right, let's go to the book of Revelation in the King James Version Bible, eh? We're going to go to the last thing that Jesus states. All right, you ready? Last thing with your Quran. I checked out the Book of Mormon. It looks the same for the most part. The golden tablets. Really? In 1830, the golden tablets. Where's the proof? Where's the evidence? And again, why? You think God made a mistake? He already knew everything that was going to happen. Why? Why? Yeah, you have no answer to that. You have no answer. What, technology? God knew Teslas were going to be made when he made Adam and Eve. You're questioning God? There's one truth, baby. Realize it. Stop copying. All right, here we go. Here we go. Revelation chapter 22, verse 19. And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life and out of the holy city and from the things that which are written in this book. He which testifieth these things saith, surely I come quickly. Amen. Even so, come Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Yeah, your Quran all edited and stuff. Boy, boy, oh boy, you better switch teams right now, baby, because you're on Satan's team. Same goes for Mormons. Same goes for Mormons. Let's think about the Jews for a second. Judaism. It's where it all stemmed. The 144,000 Mormons think that, no, excuse me, Jehovah's Witness think the 144,000 are the chosen ones that are going to heaven. So once that number's full, sorry. No. They're the chosen ones. Meaning, if we're in the end times right now, the rapture of the church, if we're in the end times, that means they're alive right now. Whether they're scientists, atheists, or Judaism, which denounces Christ. Big mistake there. But after the rapture of the church, they're going to have the seal of protection because they're going to be the disciples to spread the word during the seven-year tribulation. Timeline matters. Don't you realize that? Just use your head for a second. Don't be ignorant and realize God doesn't make a mistake. It's like, oh, shoot. There's more after the Old Testament. There's the Quran. And also another guy's going to come. His name is Muhammad. And then John. Or no, was it John? Crap. Whatever. The Golden Tablets of Mormon, okay? I will say it because I'm real, baby. A real holy temple. Repent. Ask your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, into your heart. And if you're any of these religions, denounce them. They're made from the deceiver. And boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, is he deceiving. Use your brain. Do your research. You copied the Holy Bible. Does that not tell you anything at all? And then added on to it, edited it, took stuff away. Man, the devil is alive and well.